Hello everybody, now we will be conducting the experiment speed control of universal motor. It is called a universal motor because when the current is in positive or in the negative direction, it is going to get effect, it will affect the field as well as the armature windings together. Simultaneously, the armature and the field windings of this universal motor is going to get affected, whether it is in positive or in current is in negative direction. So because it is getting because the armature and field windings are getting affected simultaneously, the direction will be always positive. The torque will be positive as well as the direction will always be positive. Therefore, it is called a universal motor. Therefore, it can work both in AC as well as DC supply. To control the speed of the universal motor, we will be using a switch. The power switch that we will be using is an SCR, that is TYN604. The speed of a universal motor can be controlled either by phase angle control method or by pulse width modulation chopper control. In phase angle control method, the speed of the universal motor is controlled by controlling the conduction time of this SCR. And in pulse width modulation control method, the AC line voltage is switched at high frequency using a power switch. Here what we are doing in this experiment is using the phase angle control method, and the switch we will be using is the SCR TYN604. By controlling the on time of this SCR, conduction time of this SCR, the voltage across the universal motor is varied and the speed will be varied. The conduction time is varied by varying the firing angle. The firing angle is varied by varying the R value. When R value is more, this capacitor will take more time to charge, the firing angle will be more, conduction time will be less, voltage will be less, speed will be less. If R value is less, this will get charged quickly, firing angle will be small, conduction time will be more. The RMS voltage that will be the average RMS value what you get here will be the across the motor will be more, speed will be more. By varying the conduction angle, we will be varying the RMS value that will be given to this motor and thereby the speed of the motor. The circuit is rigged up as shown in the figure. This is the waveform across the motor and this is the voltage supply. The voltage that is there across the motor. This is the pot. As I am varying the pot, you see the firing angle is varied. When the firing angle is more, the voltage is around 18 now. You have the firing angle is more here, the voltage is around 18. We will check the speed now. Speed is around 559 RPM. Now, we will decrease the firing angle. See, we have decreased the firing angle. The voltage here is around 22. And now we will check the speed. The speed is 691. From 550, it has gone to 691. So, if the firing angle is reduced, the voltage will increase, the speed will increase. This firing angle is varied by varying the pot. Let's vary the pot, we will vary the charging time of the capacitor, the firing angle, then the conduction angle, then the voltage across the universal motor. And using these values, if you are taking the values, you can plot the graph across the firing angle and the speed. Thank you.